Right friends, welcome back to first capsule of this week. This is with regard to important cabinet decisions taken this week. The first one is with regard to reducing the government's stake from 100% to 75% in 5 general insurance companies. And here the headquarters of these general insurance companies I have given here. Other important aspect, you should have clear idea about GIC reinsurer. This General Insurance Corporation of India, that is a GIC, is a reinsurer. This is different from other 4 general insurance companies, and this is a reinsurer. The meaning of a reinsurer is it takes part of the risk of the insurance companies. This is India's only reinsurer. Then second point is GICRE is associated with the creation of India Nuclear Insurance Pool. India created rupees 1500 crore India Nuclear Insurance Pool, and GICRE is associated with that. These 2 points you should not forget when you think about GICRE. And let us come back to the discussion. Here government decided to reduce their stake from 100% to 75%. So government of India at present is totally having ownership with these 5. Here government of India has got 100% share. That's why they are called public sector private limited companies, and in future they will become public sector public limited companies. That is the meaning of reducing the stake from 100% to 75%. And if you look at further points, the 5 companies will be listed in stock exchanges, and due process with regard to SEBI as well as IRDAI will be followed. And what are the advantages of listing? Advantages of listing, or you can say advantages of bringing some public shareholding into public sector companies, is basically improvement in accountability, improvement in transparency, and reduction in lethargy. So they will become more and more accountable, more and more transparent, and at the same time lethargy will be reduced, and corporate governance practices will be improved because somebody is there to question these government entities, and risk management practices will also lead to improved efficiency, and they need not depend on government for their expansions, and they will have alternate mechanisms for obtaining funds from the market instead of government. Right, let us look at the second one. Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs delegated powers to a select group of ministers. This select group of ministers will include Finance Minister Arun Jaitley. So it is delegated to select group of ministers with regard to modalities to be followed with regard to minority stake sale in public sector undertakings. Public sector undertakings, minority stake sale. Please look into this slide. I told you several times, minority stake sale is just selling 5%, 10%, and government retains majority shareholding, and strategic sale is totally selling it, or government coming out of majority shareholding, or government coming out of management control. That is a strategic sale, and this cabinet decision is with regard to minority stake sale. Here, when minority stake sale of 5%, 10% takes place in BHEL, Coal India, NTPC like that, then the committee, or you can say select group of ministers, will take the decision, and this will have Finance Minister as a member. Right. Look at the next one. This is another important aspect. Union Cabinet approved amendments to modified special incentive package scheme, or MSIPS. This MSIPS, this is modified special incentive package scheme. Basically, this is with a view to incentivize investments in electronics sector. And electronics sector basically requires This type of incentives and the goal of the government is basically to make net zero imports in electronics by 2020 very important. The main goal of the government is we should be self-sufficient in producing electronic goods, and the main goal is net zero imports in electronics by 2020. And if you look at the scheme further, this is basically MCIPS is the program approved in 2012 to provide special incentives to promote large scale manufacturing in electronic system design and manufacturing sector or ESDM sector, and here subsidy will be provided in capital expenditure. When you are establishing electronics industry with 1 crore investment in an SEZ, if you are establishing an electronics industry in an SEZ with 1 crore investment, then government will give subsidy of 20%. And if you are establishing in a non-SEZ, 25% subsidy in capital expenditure will be given. So that is the main purpose of this modified special incentive package scheme. And this was amended in August 15, and it overall has a positive impact on investment as per the government bulletin. And if you look at the present decision, government has now given incentive commitment of rupees 10,000 crore. Government now has given further incentive commitment of rupees 10,000 crore, and the main purpose is to have net zero imports in electronics sector by 2020, and these incentives will be available for investments made within 5 years from the date of approval of the project. This is all about this modified special incentive package scheme to further incentivize investments in electronics sector. 2-3 things don't forget. The commitment by the government is rupees 10,000 crore, and the goal is to have net zero imports by 2020, and the third point is 20% as well as 25% subsidy on capital investments in electronics sector are being given under this scheme in SEZs as well as non-SEZs. Right friends, with this let us look at the next one. Cabinet approved the establishment of Indian Agricultural Research Institute, Jharkhand. All of you are familiar with the world-class organization IARI, which is available at present in Delhi. In fact, this IARI was first established in Bihar in 1905 in a place called Pusa in Bihar. That's why IARI is called Pusa Institute, and subsequently it was shifted to Delhi in 1940s or so, and now IARI will be established in Jharkhand. Right? Look at the next one. The corpus of CGT MSE. Please don't forget, this is Credit Guarantee Fund Trust for micro and small enterprises, and this is established by Government of India as well as SIDBI. This is Credit Guarantee Fund Trust for micro and small enterprises. Basically, this gives credit guarantee to micro and small enterprises. When loan is given for micro and small enterprises, the credit guarantee is given by CGT MSE. And normal circumstances, some collateral security is required. If I am asking for some loan, bank will ask for some collateral security, but micro small enterprises may not be able to give collateral security, and that security to the bank is given by CGT MSE. This is Credit Guarantee Fund Trust for micro and small enterprises. For that purpose only, this is established. And now, 3 things please don't forget. One is the corpus given by the government to CGT MSE. Previously, it was rupees 2500 crore. Now, it is enhanced to rupees 7500 crore. This is one important decision. And the second decision is coverage of loans under credit guarantee. Previously, the limit was rupees 1 crore. And on 31st December, the Prime Minister announced that it will be rupees 2 crore. So, the credit guarantee for micro and small enterprises now increased from rupees 1 crore to rupees 2 crore. And another landmark development is this credit guarantee will cover the loans given by NBFCs also. When NBFCs, non-banking financial companies, are giving loans to micro and small enterprises, then also this CGTMSE credit guarantee will be applicable. Previously, it was not applicable for NBFCs, and now it will be applicable to NBFCs also, just like banks. And here, please look into this. This is the differentiation between banks and NBFCs. NBFCs also play a substantial role and important role in the Indian financial system. Please don't forget. Now, CGTMSE credit guarantee will not only applicable for banks, but will also be applicable for the loans granted to micro and small enterprises by NBFCs. Right, friends, look at the next one. Union Cabinet approved for introduction of repealing and amending Bill 2017 to repeal 105 acts. After this government took over, the main task is to repeal the old laws. And in that direction, Union Cabinet has taken a decision to repeal 105 acts. And remaining information I have given here, please go through it. The last decision is Union Cabinet gave approval to exclude state governments or UTs with the legislature except Arunachal Pradesh, Delhi, Kerala and Madhya Pradesh from National Small Savings Fund investments from 1st April 2017. States are borrowing from National Small Savings Fund. You may have a doubt, what is a small savings? Please look into this. These are small savings schemes, and small savings schemes are monitored by the Ministry of Finance. And another important aspect is every 3 months interest rates are being announced nowadays. Every 3 months interest rates are being announced for these small savings schemes, and these are monitored by the Ministry of Finance. That is another important aspect. And from National Small Savings Fund, except 4 states, the other states will not borrow. And why? The reason is, when they borrow from external sources, the costs associated with it will be less in comparison to small savings funds, because small savings instruments have slightly higher interest in comparison to others. So, 14th Finance Commission also recommended that state governments be excluded from the investment operations of NSSF. So, this decision is in line with the 14th Finance Commission report also. Right, friends, with this let us conclude the cabinet decisions. So please do join for other capsules. We are deliberating on graded response action plan and at the same time universal basic income. Right, have a nice day. Thank you.